always wanted to say that. As I prepare for college this fall, I've spent some time reflecting on my life until this point and what might be coming my way in the future. I've thought a lot about the people who matter most to me in my life. On the top of that list are my parents. Sometimes we don't see eye to eye, but I know that they will always love and support me. For example, I play volleyball and softball at school, and at least one, if not both, of my parents are there every game cheering me on. My family has been very involved in church over the years. This is mostly because my family values church, but partially a side effect of having a parent work here. Growing up, we always came to church as a family, even when I wasn't quite so willing to roll out of bed early on a Sunday morning. They set the example in my life that church is important, and their example has helped me to grow in my own faith. Another important person in my life is my brother Braxton. He might be a slightly different story. We fought a lot growing up, like most siblings do, but I think, fingers crossed, we've finally grown to love and support each other unconditionally. I hope he feels the same way. I love the moments when he brings his computer to my room to show me a funny video, or how he got me obsessed with the show Stranger Things, or how we have a 97-day streak going on Snapchat. I'm blessed to have such an amazing family at home, and I'm so grateful to have my St. James's family too. One of my friends recently said something along the lines of the church is its people. This church is its people. This community of doers has supported me throughout my life in so many ways. One of my first memories of St. James is in the third grade, volunteering at Vacation Bible School. Children participate in VBS until second grade, but in third grade you can start volunteering. That's what I did. I was a shepherd with another adult leader. We made sure our group got from class to class. I was still a child myself, but I was given responsibility. Having a meaningful role at VBS made me feel special. It made me feel like a doer. Not to mention, I got my own counselor t-shirt. This is the first memory I have of volunteering at church, and I really enjoyed it. It started my interest in service that later became mission work. Growing into my place in the church took a few more years. Youth choir was a big part of that. The general feeling for me as a sixth grader was, oh my gosh, there are seniors in this choir. I get to sing with them. Whoa. And at the same time, hoping they wouldn't smite me with their upperclassmen stare. I hope I've done a little better than that. I started in the front row and waited years to earn my place in the back row. Our amazing choir directors, Virginia and Mark, give us very challenging music and push us to learn it. There is certainly a sense of accomplishment when I master a new piece or earn a solo. And as I've grown into youth choir, I've grown into my place among St. James, bringing incredible music to our worship services. I know I'm contributing and sharing what I can with our community. I'm always so grateful for the love I receive after I perform in youth choir. It means so much to me when the people of our church support me with their gratitude. I want you to know how grateful I am to each of you. The doers of this church have encouraged me throughout the years and inspired me to engage in mission work myself. This is where I really came to understand that the church is not a building, it is the people. I've had the chance to go on two mission trips to Hurley, Virginia, and Appalachia. These trips have been opportunities to build relationships with my fellow youth and with the people in Hurley. Some of my best friends at church have come from our shared mission experiences. It's amazing how well you can get to know people when you're stuck in a car with them for 8 hours. In Hurley, one of the men that we worked with, Junior, is one of the most faithful people I know. He has the utmost confidence and trust in God, and that God has a plan for him and for all of us. Junior lost his leg in an accident several decades ago. I would assume that for most people, they would turn from God when something like this happens, but not Junior. He shared his story and his faith with the St. James youth on the trip and made a lasting impression on all of us. In fact, this past fall, Mary Beth gave us the option to choose from multiple other mission trip locations. The youth all voted to go back to Hurley to be with the people we've grown to care for. Building relationships with Junior and that entire community is one of the things that makes this trip so special. All of the people and experiences that I've had through St. James have shaped who I am today. I know that I am valued. I know that I'm supported. I know that I belong. And thanks to this, I feel prepared to be a doer myself. I have so many wonderful memories of St. James. Mission trips, Snowfest, PYM, confirmation, youth choir, acolyting, Sunday school, and youth group, far more than I have time to mention here. If you haven't caught on yet, I'm a total church kid. I try to do all the things that make St. James the community we know and love. I'm starting new adventures, but wherever I go, I will remember that the church is its people. I hope that you will too, wherever you are on your journey. I will be back, so don't forget about me. But in the meantime, I will always be a doer wherever I go. Thank you.